Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am also an advanced certified QuickBooks Pro Advisor, as well as a financial controller serving nonprofits nationwide by helping them to increase profitability one mission at a time. Today, I am going to show you how to create classes and locations inside of QuickBooks Online. The class feature inside of QuickBooks Online is suited to track the three core functional expenses of a nonprofit's Form 990: admin, program, and fundraising are the typical classes for a regular nonprofit. For churches, your classes will be fund types such as the general fund, program fund, and board designated fund. Remember, your charts of accounts tracks what donations you brought into the organization, what you spent those funds on. Classes, on the other hand, tracks why you collected the funds and why you spent the funds. Let's get started with creating classes in QuickBooks Online. To set up classes, click on the gear icon and Accounts and Settings. Click on the Advanced tab. Scroll to where it says Track Classes and click it. Check the box next to Track Classes to turn it on. Check the box next to Warn Me when a transaction isn't assigned to a class. You also want to keep the default option under Assign Classes as one to each row in transaction. Click Save and Done to exit the settings screen. To create your classes, click the gear icon. Under the list columns, select all lists, then click classes. Click new to create your classes. I recommend adding numbers in front of your classes in the order you want it to display on your reports. Here I am actually creating admin, program, and fundraising as my three classes. Now that you have created your classes, there are two important rules to remember when using class tracking in QuickBooks Online. These rules are: all transactions must always be assigned a class when recording sales and expenses. QuickBooks Online will alert you with a pop-up window to enter a class for a transaction before saving it if you forget to do so. The second feature you need to turn on in QuickBooks Online is location tracking. With the recent FASB financial reporting changes for nonprofits, you now have to track the condition of your donations in a new format that is easier for the public to understand. The new format requires you to show your balance sheet accounts in two columns that says with donor restrictions and without donor restrictions. To comply with this new format, we are going to use location tracking inside of QuickBooks Online. To set up locations, you're going to click on the gear icon, then Accounts and Settings, select the Advanced tab, scroll to the Categories Settings section, check the box to turn on locations. You can select either a department or division as a location type. Then click Save and Done. To create your locations, click on the gear icon and select all lists, then click on the location type name you chose earlier. Click the new green button to create your locations. Again, I recommend adding numbers in front of your locations so that they are in the correct order for your reports. Enter only two locations called without donor restrictions and with donor restrictions. Leave the remaining options unchecked in the pop-up window, then click Save. Some rules to keep in mind when using locations in QuickBooks are: number one, you can only assign one location to a sales form or an expense form inside of QuickBooks. All transactions must always be assigned a location. QuickBooks Online will not alert you with a pop-up window if you forget to assign a location to a transaction. I recommend running the profit and loss by location report and the balance sheets by location reports each month to make sure all of your transactions are assigned to a location. This is vital if you are using a third-party system that integrates with QuickBooks Online. You must remember to go back and add the location to those transactions that were imported into the system. That is a quick tutorial on how to set up classes and locations inside of QuickBooks Online. Thank you for watching. If you have questions about QuickBooks Online, you can email me. My email address is ufuma@goshenbookkeepingcc.com. Stay tuned for the next QuickBooks Online topic.